Hey, what's going on, everybody? Happy Friday, Saturday night. I don't know what time I'm putting this up, but I do know that the good folks at Preview World have sent me more omnibuses to review. So I'm going to start out with another one. I'm just going to grab it. So while you look at the shine of my head, it looks like today we're going to be looking at Marvel's Predator, the original year's Volume 2. This is really good. I've read all the originals. This is a mini-series collection, essentially. It is censored. There are a few issues missing. I can't review the issues because it's been so many years since I've read them. I know there's one that deals with the Predators going after some Nazis, and the cover is like the Predator holding a swastika flag. There's a couple things that they've censored, and by censored, I mean they just didn't include it in here. Don't worry, it costs the same. But that's okay, because it is a really, really good collection, because hunting season begins again. Marvel's doing a good job, and this one's basically a miniseries collection, and the spine will match Volume 1, because I don't know about you, but I like my spines to match. My X-Men, I've had to get first print, second print, third print, you know, like that, so my spines are all messed up on some of them. This one is going to collect Predator Hell and Hot Water, Predator Primal, Predator Nemesis, Predator Captive, Predator Homeworld, Predator Xenogenesis, probably said that wrong, sorry, Predator 2009, Predators Beating the Bullet, Predators Preserving the Game, Predator Hunters 2, Predator Hunters 3. Then it does have some material from Dark Horse Presents, which is, that's an old book. That's 86. It's 124. And it has the free comic book Day Predator from 2009. Hunting season begins again. I love the cover, but I'm a Predator junkie. Unpopular opinion. I actually like Predator 2 more than I like Predator 1. I like the city setting. I think it's really cool. You know, it's got Gary Busey. You don't go wrong with Gary Busey, even though he plays kind of like a straight-laced guy. But let's take this, let's put it underneath the camera. By camera, I mean my phone, because I haven't gotten anything I've ordered yet. And let's take a look at it. Okay, like I said, we're not too high-tech, still using the phone. But this is Predator, the original year's Omnibus Volume 2. Let's take this gimmick off first, the dust cover. Because you never want to look at anything with a dust cover on it, even though it tells you what you have, because you want the dust cover to be nice and clean and separate. I love the dust cover, though. Check that out. The spine matches perfect. That's something I like. I like how the back gives you the breakdown, has you the covers, tells you everything. Parental advisory. Don't forget about that, children's. So here it is. I always like the covers on these Marvel books. I think they look really slick. You know, downside without the, you know, I mean, you got to go by the spine on them. It's a wraparound, but it's still pretty slick. I'm, once again, not going to do a lot of spoilers. This is some old Dark Horse stuff. So as you can see, the artwork is not as, it's not like what you expect today, but it's still slick. You have Predators, you know, they're under the sea. I'm kind of flipping through it. Like I said, all the miniseries were good. The art is good. It's not as detailed. You know, here's Predator Primal. This one looks a little slicker. I could do without seeing a Predator gut a deer. But I like the aspects. A lot of these in the beginning had the old school, like, jungle settings, like the original movie. You know, I mean, the Predator, don't get me wrong, he's killing people. Because, you know, people in these movies and in this franchise, they're the meat. You know, nobody cares about them. If you get emotionally involved in the people in the movies, then you have a problem with the movies. You know, Dark Horse Presents, this is a nice black and white. And personally, I like the black and white. I would love to see what Tim Vigil would do with, hey, I look trash. What would do with something like this franchise, you know, because I think his artwork is so amazing. You know, Nemesis, that's another one that's, a lot of it's in cursive. The narrative, it's a different story. All these stories are good. There's some that are dated. I'm not going to say they're not. There are a few dated storylines in here. I mean, you're talking about a lot of books from the 80s. So fans of today's work, especially today's art, which
The art in comic books is so amazing now. It does kind of make, I don't want to single out the Predator. It does make it seem a little more, as you can see, kind of simplistic. But that's all books from that era. You know, nothing was over. What's cutting edge then is not cutting edge now. Predator Homeworld, it's really good. I like that one. That's another one that has some very bizarre artwork to it. A lot of the artwork's weird, but, you know, it's what you expect. It's your predators. Your predators are hunting people. That's what they do. You're on the home world here. You learn, I mean, you don't learn a ton about their origins. You learn some, a little more. So if you're a fan of the movies, you know, I would definitely recommend picking these up. If you're a fan of the Predator like myself, it's definitely a read. I mean, I highly, highly recommend you grab this. Like I said, some of the art, now some of the art, like, looks okay. I mean, all of it looks okay. It's just, I know people have never read this, you know, they're going to look at it, and then they're going to look at, like, some of the modern books, and be kind of like, you know, what is this? What am I looking at? This was, you know, Dark Horse. This was cutting edge. You know, Marvel has this franchise now. It is a good book, though. All these stories are really, really good. You know, if you bought Volume 1, you definitely want Volume 2. I like that there's a lot of settings in these stories where the Predator comes to, I mean, he comes to our world in the movies, but, like, where he comes to, like, more populated settings, like cities, or, you know, even smaller countries. I like that because, you know, like I said in the beginning, I really like Predator 2. I like that aspect of, you know, I've seen the jungle hunting, and this will give you both. This is going to give you the jungle hunting. It's going to give you city environments. It's a really, as you see me flip through it, whoa, look at that. It is a really good book, and I would highly recommend anyone, as I really hunk through it now. It's very fun. You know, if you're a fan of the Predator, pick it up. If you like the Punisher, I mean, I gotta say pick it up. These are really, really good stories. Marvel, they're doing a really good job with this license. I like that they're collecting all this old stuff. Tracking down some of the old stuff is a pain in the ass. Just get the Omnibus. I am not one, you know, if you just want to read a comic, which is what a comic is made for, get the Omni. I mean, that's what these are for. These are really slick. I like the designs of the Predator, and he always does change from book to book. Every artist, as you can see, has a different version of him. So my advice to you would be to pick up Predator Omnibus Volume 2, add it to your collection, make sure you have Volume 1. It's a 4 out of 5 star book for me. Pick it up today. Great series. I really like that Marvel is collecting these. Being they have the Predator now, I think that is so cool. I loved their Predator miniseries from maybe about a year ago. Is that 2023, I believe? Maybe 2022? I can't remember. Lockdown kind of made comics hot again. And then Unlockdown kind of made them unhot again. I don't know. I don't personally, nothing to do with the book. This is not the time to sell your comics. If you have comics, hold on to them. And I really do hope to be a channel that helps you with comics. I love comics. You know, my goal is I get a lot of Omnis, and there's a lot of them that I don't even read. Like, and I won't cover those, don't worry. But there's a lot of them I don't even read because I'm saving them for, I'd like to say, my retirement, so then I have, like, tons and tons of books to read. Or during the next pandemic, to then where I'm going to have to, you know, basically sit in my house, and after you get bored with TV, after, like, boy, getting bored with TV takes a while, but you have to get bored with TV, then you gotta read, you're gonna read. I like my comics. So I've been saving a lot of stuff for when that happens. Hopefully it happens during my retirement, which I'm still a ways from, even though I got some silver in the fox here, but this was Predator. Marvel's Omnibus Volume 2. I highly recommend you pick it up. I got a Previews World link in the description. Pick it up, read it, pick up part one first, because I'm not saying you need to, because it's a miniseries collection, but it just looks friggin' cool. I wish I had more Predator stuff. I don't think I have any Predator stuff except some random figures, but thank you for watching. Come back tomorrow. I'm gonna have something else for you, I promise.